If you found this video, you've probably got some uninsulated terminals that you need to crimp. So what we're going to look at in this video is how we crimp these, how we prepare the wire, the tools we can use, how we assemble these little covers, and more importantly, how we can take them apart if we need to service them. So when we're done, we'll sacrifice one of these, cut the edge off, so get a close-up inside of what's actually going on. All we're going to use is a decent pair of wire cutters. We'll have a small flat-bladed screwdriver for when we're done. These are a set of automatic wire strippers. These ones have got an adjustable tension, and also you've got a depth that you can set on this to make the stripping more repeatable. And then we're going to be using non-insulated ratchet crimpers. So what we've got a male and a female non-insulated crimp. These are 6mm spade terminals, and what this will allow us to do is when they're in their housing, we'll be able to easily connect and disconnect the wire. So if we start with the male first thing we need to do is strip the outer casing back to expose the copper to give us something to electrically connect to. So for that we need to offer up our cable, and we need the copper to be just past these little lugs here, because these are going to fold over. When we put these in our tool, what will happen is it will fold the ends over and curl it in on itself, forming this kind of shape which will bite down into the wire and hold it tight. So these ones have got a depth, you can set the depth, but if yours haven't, once you strip the wire, if it's too long, just offer it up in here. If it's too long, it's sticking out too far, you can always just trim the end with a pair of wire cutters. You don't want it too long, especially on the female version, otherwise it can poke through the actual terminals and affect or prevent this from going fully home, and it won't go in properly. If we look at this connector, you'll see there's two sets of tabs. The front are shorter than the rear. Now the front ones are for the copper, so the copper's going to lay in here, be crimped down, and provide an electrical connection between the metal of the connector and the copper in the cable. This back tab, they're longer. The reason being is they're going to clamp round and secure the outer casing of the cable. So they need to be a little bit longer, but again, they're going to fold in on themselves and grip the outer casing of this. So now we've got our cable stripped. On these non-insulated crimpers, you'll see the jaws are different sizes. The front is always the smallest and the back is always the largest. And there's two sides to them. So you've got the larger side, which is for the longer tabs, and the shorter, or the smaller side, is for the front shorter tabs. So if we lay that in here, I find it easier just to locate it in the top one, and you want the edge or the gaps, the edge of the front one, the edge of the rear one, there's a gap between these jaws. We want it to sit just in there. So if we can get that in there like that, that's going to hold it secure. Now we know our copper should stick just through the end of this, so if we now put the cable in, you might need to turn it slightly just to get it to wangle in, but don't force it, otherwise you'll bend the strands back and you'll end up with a messy connection. Now it's as simple as give it a good squeeze until it locks down, and then really is just as simple as that. Now if you use a larger connector and you put it in the wrong jaws, if it's too small, you can take chunks out the side of it and damage the connector. Same as if it's you use too large a jaw, it won't crimp it far enough. Now sometimes these back ones won't fully crimp, so what you can do is you can move it from the front jaw, move it forward and across to the next one up, and that might be just enough to give you the crimp. Just be careful you don't damage this cable. So the female connector is exactly the same. So we strip the cable. See, that lays in there quite nicely. So rinse and repeat. We'll put it in there. We'll try it in the second one. See if that does a nicer crimp. Pop that in, copper's just sticking through. You don't want it sticking through too far because you don't want to crimp any of the insulation of this outer sheath, the outer cable in the front set of tabs. Now if you've gone too far back, you'll see that it's just not folded that front part over. This is still perfectly serviceable, but if you do that, don't panic. You can just pull your connector back a little bit and re-crimp it, and then it'll complete the crimp at the front. Same again, this hasn't really crimped the back, so we'll move it over to the front of the next size up. These covers, these are hard plastic. What these will do, they'll insulate these connectors from any or from arcing out on anything, but also makes it easier to pull them apart or disconnect them and to hold them in place. What you do is you push it in from the back, and again, if you've got too much copper sticking out, it can affect the way the little plastic lug that locates behind our tab. See our little spike there? That's what's going to hold this in place. So if you've got too much copper sticking out, you'll have to flatten it down or trim it off if possible. There's the click, and that's now in. Same for the female. Make sure you get this around the right way. So you'll see this cut out. That's where the tab goes that locks it in place. And you'll see there's a divider in the middle there that sits between these two grooves. Same thing again, pop it in. Nice secure click. Now it's as simple as popping them together. Obviously this isn't waterproof, but inside the car or the vehicle or whatever project you're working on should be fine. But now it's easy to connect and disconnect this cable. So now we've done that, let's look at taking them apart. So on this male connector, we can see we've got easy access to the tab. So get a small watchmaker screwdriver, fold the tab up, and we're holding the cable and just pushing slight pressure forward so that it doesn't catch. And then once we've pulled that tab up or folded it up, we can pull the cable out. And then we'll reset this little tab here. Just bring it up so it can click back in. On the female side, it's slightly different because we can't see it as easily. But the same process applies. We're going to push this cable that way very gently so that our hook doesn't catch when we try and flatten it. So if we push it this way, you can hold it with your fingers and then grip the connector. Flat bladed screwdriver or a small drill bit will do it. You don't want anything too fat because otherwise you're going to bend this terminal up and then you'll have to straighten it out. They're fairly forgiving, but obviously prevention is better than the cure. So we'll put that in and then a little bit of a bend. And then it comes out. And all we've done is flattened that tab. So same thing again, if you go through these two bits here, you can then bring the tab back up. And then that's ready to go back in. But we'll cut this open so you can see what we're doing. See, that's basically how these go together now. So if we put the connections in them, so when we put our female terminal in, that's the divider, goes between the two sides of this connector. There's our little catch, and that's the little lug there is what it acts against. So as it goes in, there's our click. Now it's gone over there like a barb of a hook, and you can't pull it back out. So that's the female. With the male, that goes in through here, similar sort of thing. There's our click, and it won't pull out. And obviously the side's missing, so we can come out this way. But if I hold it in there, you can see what happens when we put these two together. It lines up, goes in, click, pushes it together, and it'll be held together by the plastic. Obviously the sides are weak now. So that's where we get our connectors together. Now when we're taking these apart and we're removing it, if you look at this one, the male, all we're doing is we push it forward a little bit so it doesn't catch on this lug. We put our screwdriver in, push the lug down, now that can be pulled out. Same with the female, similar sort of thing, but it's obviously a bit more enclosed. So same again, we're going to push the terminal this way to take any pressure off this lug. See, we just, you don't have to move it by much, but just a little bit. Put your screwdriver in, and the same thing again. Now this is weak because obviously I've cut it in half, but you lever against this, close that lug up, and then that will allow it to go past this lump or this molding, and it comes out. Now obviously this is in pieces, so that you've got no strength, it's going to bend. But when this is together, it's just enough to push that flat, or get it flatter so it can move past that lug. And then again, to reset it, we just put the screwdriver in through here, find where the lug was pressed out of it, push it out, and then as it goes back in, and in it goes. So if you've got a better understanding of how these go together, it makes taking them apart a lot easier. Main problem is people pull this and act on that, and what you can actually do then is this little lug, you can bend it back on itself so it forms like a hook. Now it won't go forwards and it won't go backwards, and it makes the whole getting the whole thing apart a lot more difficult. If you found this useful, if you could subscribe, help me grow the channel, and I'll see you on the next one.